Okay, today we're going to do the assembly of the 4413, the 4113 inlet. And I've laid out all the components for one inlet here. So first thing you do is I just take an end cap. Then you take one of the profiles, the long profiles. This is the one that has the groove in it for the hinge. You just determine which is the bottom of the cap here, and you can kind of tell that. It'll really only go together one way, so. Slide that down into position. Take the other half. Slide them down into the end cap, and I just take it and set it down on the floor. I take my hinge, slide it into the groove. Slides down in there freely. Take my blade, take the groove of the blade, and slide it onto this hinge material here. Seat it down all the way. Take the other end cap and install it onto these profiles. I just take it back up on the table. I take me a mallet and you just tap these ends in until these holes line up. Once you get those holes lined up, you just take and drive these plastic nails in into position. Do the other side. We take it and flip it upside down. We're going to do this last side. Okay, now that we've got it all assembled, just take and open and shut the blade. Make sure it works freely. This one does. Okay, now that we've got our inlet all put together, we're going to go ahead and we're going to actually mount it into the wall. You'll have to have your framed opening, and that you'll want to look on your instruction sheet to make sure you have the right framed opening for the right inlet. But we've got this framed in for this. This is the 4413. We're going to go ahead and we're going to stick her into the hole of the wall. Go ahead and screw the sides on first. And what we're using here is it's a 2-inch wood screw. It's actually the same style of screw that you use for like putting steel on the side of a building, but it's just a simple 2-inch screw with a little washer on it. Okay, we've got the four corners done, or this end caps. Now we're going to go in, we're going to put one right in the center of this bottom profile. Just make sure that this bottom is staying straight. And just go ahead and screw one right through that housing. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and do the top. And on this top, we want to raise this. We like to raise the center about a quarter of an inch from being straight across, and then go ahead and mount that. And what that does is that allows that inlet, it's going to actually hit on the outside corners, and it'll suck that center in. It just helps give you a lot better seal across the top. That looks good. Okay, now that we've got it all installed, you would need to take a caulking gun, and you want to caulk all the way around the perimeter. This inlet, you should have it sealed up so you'll get the proper airflow and get it all coming through the inlets without any leakage on the sides. Now we're going to go in and we're going to install our pull line, or this is the pulley that we're going to use to pull the door shut. Basically, just shut the door, line it up with the hole in the blade, and then just go ahead and you screw this pulley just right above the inlet. Once we've got this pulley into place, then you just go ahead and you put your string through the hole in the blade, right through the pulley. Now your inlet's ready to shut. Check it a few times, make sure there's no restrictions. It should open and shut real freely. This looks pretty good, actually. Okay, then the last thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put the shut off. So if you wanna lock the inlet shut or keep it from opening, we have the shut off. And basically, just put it right above the inlet. Make sure you're not interfering with your pulley. Pull and just screw that into the wall there. Then you just make sure that you've just keep screwing it in until it locks the door shut. Okay, there it's locking the door shut. You just turn it up and it'll allow the inlet to open and shut.